Giovanni Toni, we have got an exciting hour. And to start off with, look what we have.
What a combination, David. You see Ricky Steamboat in the center of the ring against Frank Lang. And, of course, the man out for Frank Lang is Joe Young. But the man on the corner of Ricky Steamboat is none other than Magnum T.A. What a combination.
Oh, that's right. Magnum T.A., one of the fastest rising wrestling stars in the world. Steamboat, he is some competitor, too. Ricky Steamboat came out of retirement for one thing. After that World's Heavyweight Championship now held by Ric Flair, he's had several chances at Ric Flair. But now, wait, let's see what happens. What happens? Good move by Steamboat. Steamboat. Lang comes over, catches him, goes down.
Not a bad move by Frank Lang, but of course, Steamboat is as quick as you can get in wrestling. Boy, the action starts out here today. Fast and furious.
That's why we say it's the fastest hour on television. Worldwide wrestling. Lane. Good move. Good move. Lane. We're getting back to Steamboat in that World Heavyweight Championship. Now Steamboat is going to have to win that United States Heavyweight Championship to get a chance at that world belt. And you know who it's held by. The man with the hardest chops anywhere, Wahoo McDaniels.
Yeah, to get that World's Heavyweight title shot, he has to go through Wahoo McDaniel, and that's a formidable task in itself. Speaking of the U.S. Heavyweight Champion and Wahoo McDaniel, Magnum T.A. is after the man. I don't know, Wahoo has gone through many opponents, David, but he may have bitten off a little bit more he can chew with someone like Magnum T.A.
That's right, when he stuck his finger in Magnum's face, because this guy, he's a ball of fire. But right now, though, Steamboat's in there. He's got Lane up. Lane's still holding on that headlock. It's over.
You know, with Magnum T.A. and, of course, Ricky Steamboat is still in the ring, but when Magnum came into worldwide wrestling, he said, I want Wahoo McDaniel.
Man, watch this. Good move, good move. Head that arm. He comes up. Magnum T.A., what a pistol he is.
Of all the wrestlers we see each and every week, this has to rank as one of the top in the entire world. He is absolutely incredible. He has had some of the quickest matches ever with that belly-to-belly suplex, and he is just incredible.
He's got a very good partner in there with Ricky Steamboat. Magnum comes up with that arm bar. Good move.
Well, the thing about Magnum T.A. is he is so quick, but he has a temper on him that when it really gets to its peak, I would not want to be against him.
Oh, you're right. And speaking of tempers, coming up, the unpredictable Dick Slater, he'll be with us. Plus, we have Don Canodal, Keith Larson, also superstar Billy Graham, the Raging Bull. And it just goes on and on, Tony.
Yeah, also, we're going to see Ivan and Nikita Koloff later on. So all the stars are here today, including this man. The man is Jesse Watts.
Look at him. Here's that temper. Takes. Oh, what? Forearm, that's a legal blow, and he just jacked his jaw.
Yeah, you're right. It was a legal blow right up against the chest of Joe Young, and it set him right down to the turnbuckles.
That's why, you know, you were talking about Magnum being so explosive. Thank you. Steamboat comes in. Let's see how the teamwork. Teamwork is very well. Got right across that arm.
Both men are physical specimens. Both are very young in the world of professional wrestling, although Ricky Steamboat has held many titles. And like you said, David, there's one that he wants, and that is the World's Heavyweight title. That's why he came out of retirement. Ricky Steamboat, however, you've watched him grow up, sort of speak, in professional wrestling.
Oh, yes.
And how much more can a man be than Ricky Steamboat is right now?
That's right. He has to win a United States heavyweight title held by Wahoo McDaniels to get that match for the World Heavyweight Championship. He's in there working on that arm now. Joe Young staying with it. Outside the ring there you see Magnum T.A. Ball of fire.
I think one thing Steamboat has developed over the years of professional wrestling is more of a game plan. When he first broke onto the scene, he was very young and he didn't have a game plan. Now he does.
Watch this, though. Good move. Magnum picks up on that team. He comes right in, goes right to that arm. He's a good team wrestler, plus he's a fantastic singles wrestler. Because, you know, we talked again. Wahoo McDaniels, like you said, Tony, I know he bit off more than he stuck his finger in Magnum's face. And Magnum's going after him. Watch this. There's teamwork again. Double elbow. Now Steamboat comes in. He takes Young. Positioning. Makes that tag. Magnum. Again. Double. Drop kick by both men. Good teamwork again.
Double standing dropkick. 4 feet hitting the chest at the same time of Joe Young, and he is now reeling.
Teamwork again. They make the tag. They come in. Oh.
Steamboat braced him for that dropkick. He braced Magnum TA for the dropkick. It was a fantastic move.
Again, teamwork again. All right. The world tip.
Into the ropes, and then you see Magnum TA's belly-to-belly suplex. Magnum TA, Ricky Steamboat are your winners.
A man that doesn't back down from anyone. The unpredictable Dick Slater.
Seriously right about that. You know, I'm getting more and more irate every single day. Because every day that I walk, I got Terry Funk, I got J.J. Dillon, I got Ox Baker. I got a lot of people after me, and the reason why is because I'm a dangerous individual. Now, J.J. Dillon, you ought to realize this, because someday, soon, in a real hurry, Dick Slater's coming after you, J.J. Dillon, and when I get my hands on you, it's not going to be funny, because I'm going to cost you more money than you're putting out to take me out of professional wrestling. Now, right here, there was a film a little while ago about Terry Funk. Terry Funk, right there, my friend. Well, Terry Funk, it took three of you. And you see, one thing about it is Dick Slater is still here. Dick Slater is still talking, and Dick Slater is still walking. Now, I've collected a lot of bounties myself, and if you're going to do the job, you better do it the right way. Because they didn't get it done, and Terry Funk, you didn't get it done. Now, listen to this, James J. Dillon. You can get all the money and all the bounty hunters you want to, but I told you before, you better do it right, and you better put me out for good, because if I get up, if I have another breath in my body, James Dillon, I am coming after you, full bore.
All right, we'll be back with more right after this. They're against Doug Bynes and Ben Alexander. And Tony, what do they have in their corner?
Well, I think our fans will notice in the upper left-hand portion of their screen, you see the Russian flag that has been posted in the corner of Don Cornuto. He's holding on to that. He calls it dirty insurance to get back the USA flag. And, of course, that's the American flag that was stolen by Ivan and Nikita Koloff.
Well, he makes that tag to Keith Larson.
Don Cornuto, his quest to get back the U.S. flag, the American flag, has taken the Russian flag. And, of course,
good move by Keith. Keith picks him up. Good slam on Vines. That's right. Look at the tag. They're tagging. Good move.
I think the fans will notice still the neck brace on Don Cornuto. He came back from a very serious injury, and he has to keep that neck protected as well he can. And, of course, he felt the brunt of Ivan and Nikita Koloff. But you know what? He comes to the ring, David, and of course we notice this, and all our fans will. The chant of USA, USA arises.
That is right. Keith, his brother, is a very inspired young man because of Don coming back into wrestling. Against all odds, he's, like you said, he's got that brace that keeps his neck from snapping back. Good fireman's carry. But they're after the Russians. Ivan Koloff, Nikita Koloff, and now Crusher Khrushchev. They are, the three of them, the world's six-man tag team champions.
That's right. We know how tough the Koloffs are. Add Crusher Khrushchev to that. You're talking about three very tough men. I'll tell you, though, the thing about Keith Larson and John Cornuto, the thing about them is the Koloffs, they've insulted their family. They've insulted their country. They've done everything they can to them, but still, guys like Don Cornuto, wearing the colors of the USA, will not give up. It's just really indicative of the spirit in the country.
All right, good move by Larson. He comes out, rolls him out. He's got it, got it. Ben Alexander kicks out. All right, Keith wisely tags Don. Don comes in, stays with that arm.
keeping Ben Alexander in the right corner and working on that arm. They're working very, very well as a combination. Well, of course, a brother combination, as it should, working very, very well.
And they need to. If they're going to defeat the Kolovs, and there are three Kolovs, that's the problem. Now, you've got that Crusher Khrushchev that Ivan's asking. All right, there you make the tag. Don made that tag. Keith comes up on that second rope. Dives off.
Yeah, David, you mentioned now they got to contend with yet another from the Soviet Union. So they got to be really on their toes. Right now, they're wrestling in the middle of the ring like they are is Keith Larson. Gives there. Doug Vines a toss right in the center of the ring.
All right, they're in control. And like we said so many times, to win the match, you have to control the match. All right, Alexander, he's got the experience on his side. He's pounding away on Keith Larson. Bends him back. Hard right into the chest. Takes him, whips him across into the ropes. Catches him with an elbow.
Yeah,
goes
you
down. Tries for that quick pin.
Well, you talked about the experience of Ben Alexander. Right now, they're working Keith Larson over quite well in their corner to control the match. This is not the corner, if you're Keith Larson, that you want to be in.
All right, he's got him up. All right, slam on that mat. Makes that tag to Alexander. Finds hold Keith down. And knee into the shoulder. Goes for the pin, but he didn't key that leg. He didn't hook that leg.
That's right, did not hook the leg. And now Keith Larson trying to fight out. Trying to maybe get back to the corner to tag in Don Cornelio. Of course, he's a long way from that corner right now.
All right, they're staying forearms in the back. They keep him in their corner. Larson trying to get out.
So far now, we'll see Alexander and Vines doing very good,
good
job.
Move. Good. All right, now he needs to make that tag. He's too far away.
Too far away from his corner is right, David. Keith Larson got a lot of determination in him, though. Still trying to fight his way out of the corner, maybe go over, make a tag. Don Cornelio trying to rally the fans behind him right now, as you see in your screen, Don Cornelio. Keith Larson really taking some punishment, still trying to fight his way over as Doug Vines comes in.
Vines goes right at the eyes. Larson, knee in the midsection. Vines goes to the back of the neck. Larson's trying to fight his way out. Snap mirror by Vines. Backs in the rope. He missed. He missed.
He's going up at the wrong part of the ring. He's at the wrong corner, David. He got up. He reached for the corner, but Don Cornelio is across the way. Ben Alexander working now on Keith Larson. Still trying to get over and touch Don Cornelio.
Knee right in that midsection. Knocks the wind out, Tony. The control is switched.
You're right, the control of the match has switched. It's definitely with Doug Vines and Ben Alexander right now.
All right. Cornuto's over there. He's facing up and down. Vines comes in. Catches Keith in that midsection. Knocks that wind out.
Keith
taking him down. His punches, they're losing their strength. He needs that tag. Don. Don's over there. He's rested. He's ready. He can carry that load.
If Keith can get over there, you are going to see a flurry come to the ring like you've never seen before. Oh, a neck breaker.
Goes for that pin. Again, he didn't hook the leg.
Had him down, did not hook the leg. A well-executed move to get him to the mat, but did not finish it off.
Right, there you go. There's that pin.
Here he comes. It's the pride of the USA, Don Cornelio. And he's working on both men now.
Nikita Koloff,
and now Don Cornelio is working on Nikita Koloff.
Oh, what's happening?
these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area.
Here's a reminder, tonight, 8:15, East Surrey High School Gym in Pilot Mountain, North Carolina, Supercar, The Barbarian, Superstar, Billy Graham, Paul Jones, Ivan Agitikolov, Dick Slater, Don Cornell, The Raging Bull, all tonight, East Surrey High School Gym in Pilot Mountain, North Carolina. Another reminder of a super spectacular card of professional wrestling coming your way at the Greensboro Coliseum, Sunday, February the 17th at 8 o'clock. On the card, you'll see for the World Six-Man Tag Team title, it's Ivan, Nikita Koloff, and Krusher Khrushchev. They will be there. Superstar Billy Graham will be on the card. Magnum T.A., Avalanche Buzz Hunter, The Raging Bull, Don Cornell, The Barbarian with Paul Jones, Black Bart, a belly match, Cowboy Ron Bass with James J. Dillon against Dick Slater. If Slater wins the match, he gets 5 minutes all alone with James J. Dillon. U.S. Heavyweight title, Wahoo McDaniel defends against Ricky Steamboat. And for the TV title, no disqualification, Tully Blanchard with Baby Doll against the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. A belly match, Cowboy Ron Bass with James J. Dillon against Dick Slater. If Dick Slater wins, he gets 5 minutes with James J. Dillon.
J.J., I'm going to tell you right now, you can come out dressed just as you are. You don't have to worry. You're not going to have to get in no ring with no Dickie Slater. Because right there in Greensboro, my friends, I'm going to take care of you, Slater. There ain't no way in the world we got kind of added advantage this time, J.J. He's going to be going out there gunning. He wants to get you in the ring. Well, son, I'm not going to let that happen, J.J.
And then you will see TV title, no disqualification, Tully Blanchard with Baby Doll against Dusty Rhodes.
You know, Dusty Rhodes, you get on television, you talk about, I'm going to bring out my 10,000 Susan B. Anthony's if I get my rules. Well, Dusty Rhodes, is this the only rule you want that I got to comply with? Well, Greensboro Coliseum, no disqualifications right down my alley. Dusty Rhodes, you had your shot last time, and you couldn't get the job done. Well, no DQ, that's fine with me. Baby Doll and I'll be there.
U.S. Heavyweight title, Wahoo McDaniel defends against Ricky Steamboat.
Well, Ricky Steamboat's reappeared. You know, this man thinks he can just come out of nowhere and come out there and take this belt away from me and do what he wants. Let me tell you something, Steamboat. I know why you came out of retirement the first time. It was to become the world champion. Well, I threw a little monkey wrench in your gears. I took the U.S. belt away from you. Now you got to work yourself back up the ladder, and you think you're going to do it by beating me. You got another thinker coming because I'm hard to beat.
Oh, they were chopping them down.
You see the man, Tony? And that's what he is. He is some man. Superstar Billy Graham, managed by Paul Jones, and Paul Jones needs all the help he can get.
I would think so. Now, we know that superstar Billy Graham, here in this match against Ron Rossi, is an incredible specimen. Kung Fu, the unbreakable Full Nelson. However, you said Paul Jones needs all the help he can get, and that's because Jimmy, the Boogie Woogie Man Valiant, is still after Paul Jones, will not let him alone, and he is back.
That's right. The Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant, he is coming back. But look, superstar Billy Graham doesn't even take his robe off, goes right after.
A master in Kung Fu, a master of the black belt, just an incredible specimen, and still now punishing Ron Rossi as the opening bell signals the start of this match. So far now stomping. We always knew he was tough and rough. However, now that he adds Kung Fu and that repertoire to his arsenal, he's even tougher.
He goes right after. Watch him. Now you're going to see how vicious superstar Billy Graham really is. Pounding away on Rossi. Rossi, no match for the superstar. Billy Graham, look at him pounding.
Those big forearm blows. He has bicep arms that are 23 inches. Look at that. 23-inch arms. Incredible.
He is superstar Billy Graham. Managed by Paul Jones. Also, Paul Jones has the Barbarian in his camp. And like we said before, he is going to need a lot more because
I would think so.
Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Van, he is coming back. All right, Rossi gets back in that ring. Superstar starts to pound away. Choppy. The back of the neck.
The thing we've seen about superstar Billy Graham so much is that he stays on the offense, does not let his opponent take a breath. Threw him on the floor, jumped down on the floor, now has him up against the ropes.
superstar. He just keeps pounding away on Rossi.
Not at all. Now he's going to tie him up near the turnbuckle. Look at this. Oh, a big blow. A big blow. Rossi was up near the turnbuckle, and that blow almost knocked him right through the ropes.
Superstar is just treating him just like a side of beef.
And now here's where you have to watch for Paul Jones. The man is down, and this is where he is at his best. But the fans diverted his attention.
They are. Usually Paul Jones would go and use that cane on the opponent. But the fans, he's more bothered by the fans than he is. Superstar still relentlessly pounds away. Rossi.
Well, Rossi has not been able to get a word in edgewise. Boy, every time he sticks his head into the ring, Superstar Billy Graham stomps, kicks, pounds on him. And now the full
there
Nelson.
Is the Python. The Python wraps around Rossi, wraps around that neck. He's got that full Nelson.
He says no man can break it.
That's
right. Ron Rossi's not going to be able to, because out goes Ron Rossi. Superstar Billy Graham will not let go. Paul Jones is coming to the ring. And as we said, in the mind of Paul Jones has to be Jimmy Valiant, because he's coming back to Worldwide Wrestling. However, there's your winner, the Massive Man.
Look at this man there, the Superstar Billy Graham.
As we said, once he gets that full Nelson clamped on, that is it. The winner, along with Paul Jones, the Superstar Billy Graham. David Crockett returns with Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll. We want you to return also.
NWA Television Champion Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll.
You know, David, it's always a great pleasure to be on national television and be able to come out here and talk to all the wrestling fans, being the NWA television champion and also bringing out here the world's perfect woman, Baby Doll, the only true 10 that there is on the face of the earth. You know, Tully Blanchard has a reputation of being quite a womanizer from one end of our great nation to the other. And, you know, a lot of the men sitting out there, you know, some of the people that I've been with might have been your wife, your sisters, maybe even some of your daughters. But I tell you what, the thing that separates the 10 from the rest of the woman population of the world, oh, I can't tell you on television. But I tell you what, Dusty Rhodes, you can be jealous and bring your $10,000 out here. Ric Flair, you can talk about pretty ladies, because I got prettier ones. I got faster cars than you, Ric Flair. Manny Fernandez, the Raging Bull, one half of the World's Tag Team Championship, Magnum T.A., Ricky Steamboat, all of y'all just come up a little bit short because Tully Blanchard and the perfect 10, David Crockett. And I catch you catching eyeballs at her. You just keep your eyes off of her. There she is. Because I tell you what, I know how to treat a woman behind closed doors and in public. Tully Blanchard knows how to make them feel like a 20 if I have to. But I tell you what, Baby Doll, say a couple of words.
Baby Doll wants to say this to all those men out there that think that they know how to treat a woman. Tully gives me a Learjet, a car, the best champagne, their best restaurant. That's how you treat a 10. And for all of you out there, you wouldn't dare get a 10.
David Crockett, you know, after listening to that, maybe someday, you will find the perfect woman for you.
We'll be back with more right after this. Every time you hear that, you know what it is, the Raging Bull. He's the one half of the World Tag Team Champions. He is something else.
And you know, David, he and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, they've held onto those titles for quite a while now.
Yes, they have.
And, you know, to defend the world's tag team title, the NWA World's Tag Team title, you have to defend that all over the world every night. And I tell you, they've come across as the champions they are.
They are champions, especially this man right there, the Raging Bull. He's a Vietnam vet. He doesn't back down from anybody. He is something else.
Absolutely not. And today against Joel Deaton, a big guy, Joel Deaton, no doubt about it. The Raging Bull, Matty Fernandez, has his hands full.
You make this man mad, you'll know why they call him the Raging Bull.
Well, I think you put it right there, David. You'll find out why they call him the Raging Bull.
Mm. All right, across, and then the ropes, comes off. Good tackle by Deaton. And he comes up, good, drops down, catch, good, good move, good move. Hip toss, arm drag, comes up, drop kick, catch right in the chest. Look at this. Man, he is good. He is sucker.
Three super moves, a hip toss, an arm drag, and a drop kick. And down goes Joel Deaton.
Hey, Tony, that's why Worldwide Wrestling is the number one wrestling program in the world. We have the very best right here.
And of course,
that's the reason why.
We've had a star-studded lineup here today, starting with Magnum T.A., Ricky Steamboat, John Kurt Odle, Superstar Billy Graham, and now this man, the Raging Bull, Matty Fernandez, one half of the world's tag team champions.
Good move. He is so knowledgeable when it comes to wrestling. And when it comes to fighting, he's just as bad.
You know, we talked about Superstar Billy Graham and his kung fu expertise. Here's another guy that knows a lot about martial arts fighting. The Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez.
Oh, quick. Snaps that wrist, the elbow.
I think one thing he does just as well as any other professional wrestler, and that is work on one part of the body. Probably does that as well as anybody else. That's why he is good as a tag team partner.
Also, Tony, if you notice him, all of a sudden, he'll be wrestling his opponent, and then it looks like an explosion. He just quickly, from one move to the other. Good switch now. Comes out. Good arm. There you go. Stays with that arm.
He is in complete control, David. Control was the word you used earlier today here on Worldwide Wrestling. And when you talk about control, you're right about this man. All of a sudden, he can use so many moves in succession, a combination of so many moves, and it's all for one end mean. And that, of course, what happened right there was to work on the arm. A nice arm drag out for the ropes.
You know, Dusty Rhodes had a very nice comment about the Raging Bull. He said, Manny Fernandez, the Raging Bull, could be the World Tag Team Champion by himself. He is so good. This man, he's a stick of dynamite, a ball of fire. What a shot!
Everybody here today in our auditorium felt that one. That knocked him right to his seat.
We'll have to sit down on that one.
My goodness. Joel Deaton tried to break away from that arm. There's no way Manny Fernandez is going to let him do that. Once again, another blow.
Takes him out. Deaton switches. Quick. That's what y'all meant, the quickness.
Super move, David. Look here.
Beautiful. Comes off, got him down, hooks that leg, and that is it.
That is it. The Raging Bull got away from that reversal by Joel Deaton. Went all the way across the ring to the other turnbuckle. As you see right here. Jumping up the middle turnbuckle and then on with a double thrust. The winner, one half of the world's tag team champions, the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. We have more action. Dick Slater yet to come. Stay right where you are.
There you see him, J.J. Dillon, with one of his bounty hunters, the Inferno. And there you see the man that he's after, Dick Slater. Slater, he's ready. He comes in the ring, chases J.J. out. Look at him, he's going after J.J. Forget the guy in the ring. He wants J.J.
He's after one man, James J. Dillon. You know, James J. Dillon has put a lot of bounty hunters here on Worldwide Wrestling after Dick Slater. But, David, I think we ought to sit back and think about it. Because these bounty hunters are no more than just roadblocks to keep Dick Slater away from James J. Dillon. Because as much as James J. Dillon is after Dick Slater is after him.
suplex. I would too, because that is absolutely no protection right there for James J. Dillon. He brought in the Inferno, and that quick. It is over.
And another bounty hunter bites the dust.
Like we said, a mere roadblock preventing Dick Slater from getting to James J. Dillon. That's what these bounty hunters are. And this time, once again, Dick Slater prevails.
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area.
There's a big card tonight at 8:15 East Surrey High School Gym in Pilot Mountain, North Carolina, with the Barbarian, Superstar Billy Graham, Paul Jones, Ivan and Nikita Koloff, Dick Slater, Don Carnuttle, the Raging Bull, all in Pilot Mountain tonight at 8:15. A big, super spectacular card coming to the Greensboro Coliseum Sunday, February the 17th at 8 o'clock. That's Sunday, February 17th at 8 o'clock. On the card, World Six-Man Tag Team Champions, Ivan, Nikita Koloff, and Crusher Khrushchev, Superstar Billy Graham, Magnum T.A., Buzz Tyler, the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez, Don Carnuttle, the Barbarian, Paul Jones, Black Bart, a bounty match, Cowboy Ron Bass, along with James J. Dillon, will take on Dick Slater. And if Dick Slater wins, he has 5 minutes all alone with James J. Dillon. U.S. Heavyweight title, Wahoo McDaniel defends against Ricky Steamboat. And then for the TV title, no disqualification, Tully Blanchard with Baby Doll against the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Let's bring in Dick Slater. If you win the bounty match, 5 minutes with James J. Dillon.
I'm going to get 5 minutes for James J. Dillon anyway. That's how I look at it. See, Dillon, I've been through every man that you have put in front of me to try to take me out of professional wrestling. Terry Funk, Ox Baker, your long riders, and now the only man I got to go through is Ron Bass to get to you. Well, I'm going to get to you anyway, James Dillon. You better gear yourself up. You better put your track shoes on, brother, because I'm tired of taking the beatings. I told you never spend a lot of money on me. You better spend a lot of money on yourself. But in the Greensboro Coliseum, I promise you, Dillon, I'm going to do you bodily harm.
Wahoo McDaniel defends the U.S. heavyweight title against Ricky Steamboat.
I like Dick Slater. Come out here and say he's going to do some bodily harm. Mr. Wahoo McDaniel's the current United States heavyweight champion. Mr. Wahoo McDaniel's probably the greatest Indian professional wrestler of all time. Get up here has made statements for the past several months now that he's going to win every match any way he can. Well, I want to make this statement to you, Wahoo. I never was much to get up here and do a bunch of yelling and screaming, but making a statement like that in our match is just not going to cut the mustard, brother. I've sat back for a long, long time now and reviewed films and watched you in matches. I've watched you against Raging Bull, against Magnum T.A., against this man and that man. I'm picking my time, and the time has come. It's right now, right here in Greensboro. You're going down for the three count, Wahoo. I'm telling you that right now.
Flair, Rick, the intensity, the feud between you and Wahoo McDaniels has gotten completely out of hand, completely.
Well, that's right. Wahoo McDaniels has told everybody he'll stop at nothing to get the world's heavyweight title. You can see a little sequence right here. Wahoo and I had a go-around. Here it is right now. I'm in my street clothes. He's in his trunks, but we're going at it anytime, anywhere. I just caught him with an elbow right here, and I'm just about to teach Wahoo McDaniels one of these superior lessons about wrestling. You can see what happened. In comes Blanchard and his little baby doll. And you can see what happened. Same story. 2-on-1, in this case, 3-on-1. They're having their jollies with Ric Flair. They're getting their best of Ric Flair right now. But David Crockett, I'll guarantee you, what you're seeing right now is only the beginning. Wahoo, you can do anything you want to me. You can do anything you want. Break an arm, break a leg. But remember one thing. I'm going to have my day with you when nobody else is around. And it's going to be in the very near future. And I don't care if it's in Charlotte, North Carolina, Greensboro, Savannah, Conway, South Carolina, Chicago, New York, Wahoo, one of us is going to walk out of this feud the better man and the world champion. This is mine right now, but I don't want it if you're a better man. I don't think you are. So, Wahoo, bring your best stuff forward. I like a fight. I like being called the best, and I want to deserve being called the best.
that means, Wahoo, I've got to take you. I've got to beat you. So, Wahoo, woo, I don't care where it is. Plan on a fight of a lifetime. This is mine until you show me different. Woo!
Of angry men we saw earlier in the program where they tried to capture the Russian flag from Don Cornuto, could not get the job done. Of course, there's something else there after. That's after the world's tag team title, both of them together. Not only that, they hold on to the world six-man tag team title. These guys live off tag teams.
Yes, they do. And they have a lot of tag teams that are after them. You know, you're talking about they're after the world tag team title held by the Raging Bull and Dusty Rhodes. Dusty Rhodes and the Raging Bull are after them. Plus, Don Cornuto with Keith Larson. Don Cornuto with other partners. You've got Ricky Steamboat. You've got Magnum TA, Dick Slater. They're all after. Look at it. Look at Akira. Look at the power in this man.
High
sheer power.
He took Lee Ramsey that time. Right on off the ropes. And now Gene Ligon comes in. And you can see how angry and determined. Look, those blows from Gene Ligon not even phasing right now. Nikita Koloff.
That is right. I remember when Ricky Steamboat came in one time to the ring. Nikita Koloff caught him from the back with that sickle of his. Almost took his head off. Steamboat, he's after these two. I tell you what, they've got a lot of people that are definitely intent on doing away with them. But these men right now, you have to admit, they're the world six-man tag team champions. Ivan Koloff, the Russian Bear, the leader of the gang. He is something. He's in there tearing at the mouth with Gene Ligon.
And along with Nikita Koloff and Crusher Khrushchev, they make the world six-man tag team champions. And like we said, you know, David, this has been a great program here today. And it's been a program of frustration for many guys. First of all, Ivan Nikita Koloff, they could not get the job done with their flag. And then James J. Dillon could not get the job done with Dick Slater.
He got so upset, he just left his bounty hunter and said, forget it.
That's right.
All right, look at Nikita. Backbreaker. Picks his man up again and just tosses him over.
Right now, content on punishing Lee Ramsey. Nikita Koloff, repeated backbreaker that time.
Nikita struts around. The arrogance. All right, watch Ivan up. Second row. Pounds away in that back.
Of course, when Ivan and Nikita Koloff are in the arena, you see more red, white, and blue, more American flags than you've ever seen in your life.
That's correct. We
have a lot of them here today.
It always gets the Koloffs upset when they see the red, white, and blue. Pounding away, put in the midsection. Ramsey trying to fight back, but he's just losing it. Nikita comes in. He's got him. He hooks those arms.
You know what makes Ivan and Nikita Koloff such a great tag team is that they're mad, they're angry, but it's a controlled anger. They are very much in control of the match at all times.
That is right. Yeah. We dislike them because of what they do, who they are, but look at Nikita. He's like a robot.
That's not bothering him at all.
Watch, makes that tag now.
Gene Ligon tried to hit Nikita Koloff. That was not even phasing Nikita Koloff one bit. Methodical, slow, but also destructive are both Ivan and Nikita Koloff.
Oh, jumps right on the midsection, knocks the wing completely out. Trying to get up.
All the way to Ivan Koloff went down on that.
Tony, Ligon, he's trying to fight it.
You can forget that. Ivan Koloff is not backing up a bit from the blows from Gene Ligon.
He's going right to the face in the mouth again, ripping at it. Referee Tommy Young calls for the break.
Absolutely no defense when someone right. like Ivan Koloff goes for the face.
Animal. Nikita slowly struts in. Ramsey tried to put in the midsection, but didn't even phase this man. The mass, the fury, Nikita Koloff.
Notice how much of this match, David, has been in the Koloff's corner.
Oh! That is it.
Incredible. Good. Lee Ramsey
took his head off.
Lee Ramsey just bullfrog leaped right over Ivan Koloff and met what they call the Russian sickle from Nikita Koloff. No doubt about it. The winners of the match, Ivan and Nikita Koloff, will see it once again. Perfect teamwork right here. Ducks out of the way, and here comes the Russian sickle.
Ricky Stimo, Magnum TA.
Here comes Don Canuto, the pride of the USA.
You know, Walt McDaniels, when your name's mentioned, people think of pride. They think of fighting men. And in your case, they think of the finest heavyweight the United States has to offer today. And what I see is a man that is so possessed with a dream, with a goal of his, to be the world's heavyweight champion, that he's totally forgot what got him there. He's totally forgotten what made him the number one contender, and that is the United States heavyweight belt. Well, this man over here beside me knows what it's like to have that belt around his waist, and he was a man that fought. He was a man who protected that belt at all costs. And that's exactly what I'm asking of you. The people of Greensboro, North Carolina, know what happened when you and I ran nose to nose, head to head. When we met, I took all the punishment. All everything you had to deal, I took. And when after it was all over, I came out on top, put you down for a 1-2-3 count. Well, all I'm asking you is to put your name on the dotted line, anywhere it might be, but put that title up. Defend it like a man that you're supposed to be. Give Magnum TA that shot that somebody gave you a long time ago, and let me have the chance to be the number one contender to the world's heavyweight title.
You know something, David? Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I'd like to bring Don Canoodle in here for a second. For the past several months, everybody around this area, I've seen this man right here defend a flag which he does not believe in, which he does not want to stand for. Everybody has seen him time and time again put the red Russian flag up in his corner. And it seems as though that he's defending it, but actually not. Using that Russian flag as bait is what he's doing. He wants to get the red, white, and blue back. And he told me that no cost will come upon him to stop him from getting Old Glory. Now, Donald, I've seen what has happened in the past. Magnum TA and I, earlier this evening, saw it happen again. Ganging up on you, trying to get that Russian flag. You can count on me. I'm sure you can count on Magnum TA anytime that you need us to call on them in a tag team combination to get that red, white, and blue back. We'll be there. I've been there for you. I'll be there again.
That's exactly right, Steamboat. You're a great man. Magnum TA, you're a great man. You're great Americans. And I'd like to say it's a lot of great Americans out there. As you said early in the match right here, you see what they did to my brother. You see what they tried to do. They tried to steal that Russian flag. Well, all you Americans out there, I want you to believe in Don Canuto. I want you to believe in America. And I'll tell you one thing right now. As long as there's one breath in my body, I'll guarantee you they're not going to get that Russian flag back. And I'll guarantee you I will get that red, white, and blue back. Koloff, you know what you've done. You've hurt my family. You've done everything. You've downtrodden all the Americans. Well, let me tell you something. That's going to come to a halt. That's going to come to a halt. You know what I can do. You know I can beat you one-on-one. And let me tell you something. As long as those American people are behind Don Canuto, it's no way you can defeat me. Like I said before, the American country is over 200 years old. And the United States has never, never lost a war. And I'll tell you right now, Don Canuto's not going to lose this war. I'm not even going to lose a battle. American people, I beg you, I want you to stand behind me. I want you to stand beside Steamboat and Magnum TA, because we won't let you down. Russia, Koloff, that dirty, trashy flag of yours, I swear to all you people right there, it's going to come to a head. And Don Canuto's going to show everybody that Russia's nothing, and the United States is number one everywhere we go. God bless the USA.
We'll be back with more next week.
Worldwide Wrestling is a presentation of the J.